Hello, this is Uma Higuchi. I have been a teacher in SFUSD for 9 years, and I'm excited to talk to you about Unit 2.2, Measuring Length. You and your students will likely start this unit in the third week of September and continue until the end of the month. This is a short but important unit. Understanding and using standard units of measure is one of the four focal areas of second grade, and length measurement is used throughout second grade as a context for a variety of word problems. The big ideas of this unit are that length can be estimated, measured, and compared using standard units. And the longer the unit of measure, the fewer units it takes to measure an object. It is important that students make connections between math they have already learned and math they are going to learn. In kindergarten, students measured by direct comparison of two objects, using terms like longer than and shorter than. In first grade, they began to compare lengths indirectly and expressed the length of an object as a whole number of iterated units that span it with no gaps or overlaps. In this unit, students began to use rulers and other measurement tools for the first time, and began to notice that the smaller the unit, the more times it must be repeated in order to cover a given length. In third grade, students will recognize area as an attribute of two-dimensional regions and relate it to multiplication. In fifth grade, they will extend these ideas to volume. In later grades, students will also see that many of these measurement ideas apply when they measure other attributes of objects, such as angle measure and mass. At the beginning of this unit, students develop an understanding of why standard units are helpful. They make rulers using 1-inch square tiles and centimeter cubes, and use them to measure classroom objects. They go on to develop a sense of the relative size of inches, feet, and meters, and decide on the best tool to use for measuring various objects. Students use rulers, measuring tape, and meter sticks throughout this unit. One of the important ideas of the unit is that mathematicians have to choose the best tool for what they want to measure. One example of how the important ideas of this unit are developed is in Lesson Series 3, where students find lengths using broken rulers, applying ideas of difference in measurement. When you sit down with your colleagues to preview this unit, I suggest you start by making the rulers described in Lesson Series 1, one with inch tiles and one with centimeter cubes. Then do the expert task together. You might take time now to assemble materials for the unit. See the resources table at the beginning of the unit for a complete list. For Lesson Series 1, you will need to assemble baggies with one straw, one new crayon, one coloring marker, and other items you choose that are approximately a whole number of inches long. By the end of this unit, students will have a deeper understanding of estimating, measuring, and operating with length. As always, if you have feedback, please go to sfusdmath.org and click on the Curriculum Feedback button. Have fun with this unit, and thank you for all that you do. We will see you again in the second week of October for Unit 2.3, Addition Within 100.